In this video, we're going to look at the canvas component in App Inventor. Right? So if we look into our components, we actually notice that canvas is not in user interface, but if we open up some of the other ones and get to drawing an animation, we see our canvas component and we can drag it onto our viewer and it just looks like this empty canvas right now. Right? We can set properties over on the right, and we've already uploaded a kitten picture to use as a background image. So if we go and set that, our canvas expands in size. We can have a blank canvas, that's fine. We will need to set a height and width of that blank canvas as well if we don't want to have a picture to form that. Okay, so fill parent and fill parent work here. We don't have any other components that we're explaining, so just canvas. And it fills up our entire screen now. All right, the other properties deal with drawing on the canvas lines and what color the lines are or text, okay? So now we can go to our blocks. And we notice we have our canvas component, and our canvas actually has several blocks. The first couple are events, right? The mustard color. Dragged, also known possibly as swipe, right? Dragged gives us a point of where we started our swipe, where we currently are, right? If we push our finger on our screen and drag it across our screen without losing contact, this is our current location of our finger on the screen, right? And then flung kind of is a flinging motion on our canvas. Touched down, right? So if we touch our canvas, touch our screen, and don't release, that's down. Touch up is when we do release. And then touched in general is when we tap, okay? So similar to a button, we can interact with a canvas. And most often we will use either touched, right, we're tapping the canvas, or dragged, right, we're swiping somehow on the canvas or drawing on the canvas, okay, but we maintain contact with our finger. The other ones we'll use occasionally, depending on the circumstance. Then we see a bunch of procedures, and we can go over them later, but basically they're for drawing or getting parts of the canvas, right? So we have draw a line. We can draw a line at a certain point or draw a circle, right? And then we have our properties, right? We can set our properties at the beginning in the designer. We could also change them through code, right? We can change the background image, the background color, the width of the line for drawing, the color that we're using to draw, and whether the width of the canvas or the height of the canvas, and whether it's visible or invisible. Okay, so those are the blocks, and just like normal, we drag them there, and then we set the actions we want to do in here, such as playing a sound or doing other logic. And that's the canvas component.